Yes, it's the original human beatbox.
I got the money. tall, handsome stranger, the one that wants to hook it up with my friend Jason, said, "You know, you look like Saddam Hussein."
Church.
right, in the front of the church, was this huge wooden statue of Jesus. And he had a wooden crown of thorns and wooden nails and a wooden loincloth and wooden blood. And I asked my mother, "Mom, is this what life's about? Death, blood, and wood?" And she responded, "Shh, Robertito, pray." So I did. Kneel, the kneel, sit. Catholic, Morse code to God. Say. Church would always bother me.
"Ay, Robertito, you look so cute in that suit."
"Robert, do you remember me? I was your babysitter when you were this small. You don't poo-poo in your pants anymore, do you, Rico?" "Robert, your parents, they have such lovely accents."
"Where are they from?"
"Oh, how exotic." "Oh, how exotic." "You ever notice that when people call you exotic, bro, they just stop and hover?" No, bro, it's just that we never seen anybody who's half Iranian and half Guatemalan in Union City, California, bro. We're just a small farm town, 45 miles southeast of San Francisco. The only excitement we ever get was when Cesar Chavez came to unionize the farm workers. You know who he is, right? Oh, you'll learn about him later. Quest, bro, I've got this question. You know how you've got, Iraq, Syria, Saudi Arabia, right? And way over here you got Mexico and El Salvador? Hey, bro, how did your parents meet? Land in Germany.
So I took another plane and landed in the land of fruit trees and abundance known as Union City, California. Where I worked and worked and worked.
Minimum wage.
Cleaning up the shit from assembly line to assembly line to assembly line.
Ooh.
Oh.
Meanwhile, in another land far, far away, called Laura, Albertina, Comparinitesis. I dream of having my own office job and a tiny little family. But instead, my Uncle Sam, offered me a green card if I would come to his house and work for him. I accepted and took a plane from that far, far, far away land of Guatemala and landed in Union City, California as well. Where I worked and worked and worked.
Minimum wage.
Cleaning up after my uncle, cleaning up after his children, his house, and even his dirty underwear. I also went to English school, where Muhammad also was. Laura, where Eric also was. Laura had long black hair and white skin and blue eyes, which made her stand out in her family obeditos, but caught my attention. I strolled on by her desk in the English school to utilize my improved English. Laura, did you know that both of our countries were the first two to be infiltrated by the CIA? would you like to join me for dinner? I saw his James Caan, Engelbert Humperdinck, Tom Jones, Bush of chest hair, and I said, he must be Latino. And we knew it was love, but Laura was unsure, so she went to the neighborhood priest. Hey, padre. I love Mohammed, but he is Muslim. I do not want to go to hell for love. What does the church think? Laura, as long as we can convert him like we converted the Indians, and he attends catechism class before the marriage, it shall be okay in the eyes of the Lord. So, on Iranian New Year's Day, Nowruz, the first day of spring, ladies and gentlemen of the congregation, I would like to pronounce to you the new couple, Laura and Eric Karimi. And 17 months later, on the one-year anniversary of the death of slain Chicano journalist Ruben Salazar and the 13th birthday of Michael Jackson, I was born! Yeah! In a tiny Union City hospital named Robert Farid Karimi. Dad said, I wanted Robert because I wanted to. For Robert to be an American, so I named him Robert. I wanted Robert to not forget where he came from, so I named him Robert Farid. Robert Farid. Lane Kennedy, my parents thought was the president of these United States. And we were a team going everywhere together. Mom and Dad both working. Me going from babysitter to babysitter to babysitter. The modern American family. Nuclear family. A man and a woman had a little baby. They were three, and that's a magic number. So, how about if you walk into a room, though, and your traditions are in no one's memory anymore? Imagine if 9/11 got banished. If an entire group didn't know about it. That's what happened when I was in Southside Chicago in 2005. I said these three words, and nobody knew what I was talking about. I asked them this question. How many of you all know about the Iranian hostage crisis? Well, yes, we have a mature crowd, yes. A classic.
Yeah.
Now, for all of you that don't know about it, you can go on Google. It's all good. You can do what you need. But I'll just give you my version, and just really quickly. If you think of 24-hour news, if you think of the word terrorist, it all started getting popularized around then. It lasted 444 days. And it was one of the only historical events in U.S. history to be counted this way. For those of you that were that are mature and around back then, did anybody know where they were on day 79? Well, I.